Emily. Today I have two Valentine's Day tutorials for you. One is a daytime look and one is a nighttime look, and they transition into each other. So you don't have to take the daytime makeup off. You simply just build on top of it, and this is the final look. I'm so obsessed with both of these makeup looks. My favorite part about it is the skin and how glowy and soft and supple and radiant the skin looks. Like, that was my number one goal, and I definitely feel like I've achieved that here. And also, you know, the daytime and nighttime, we just really switch up the lips and the eyes, and it's not that difficult. I know you can do it, and I really hope that you enjoy both of these looks. I hope that you're able to implement them on your Valentine's Day this year. I think you're really going to enjoy these tutorials, and if you wanted to see one other tutorial for Valentine's Day, I did do one last year, so I will link that down below in the description box. So let's just get into this tutorial. I know you guys don't want to hear me ramble anymore.
Okay, so we are going to do about a million and one things to prep the skin, so just bear with me. The first thing I'm using is my Nivea Men Sensitive Post Shave Balm, and I am rubbing that in until it feels nice and tacky. Then I'm using my Makeup Forever Step 1 Skin Equalizer. This is the smoothing primer, and I'm just literally smoothing this over the largest pores of my face, so that's over my chin and the tops of my cheeks and around my nose. Then for foundation, I'm literally mixing three products together because it's just over the top, and that's what I'm all about today. So I use the Double Wear Foundation from Estee Lauder, I use the Born This Way Foundation from Too Faced, and then a Radiant Primer from Laura Mercier. This is called the Radiance Foundation Primer, and I am just first putting this on with my fingers, and then I'm blending everything out with a dampened beauty sponge. I'm using the sponge to pick up the excess because obviously I'm putting a crap ton of it on my face. Then to conceal, I'm using my IT Cosmetics Bye Bye Under Eye Waterproof Concealer in the shade Neutral Medium, using my ring finger to melt that product into my under eye and just really make it look like my skin. And then again, picking up the excess using my dampened Tarte beauty sponge. To prime and prep my eyes, I am using the Too Faced Shadow Insurance. The tiniest little bit goes the longest way, and then again, picking up the excess with a sponge. To set my face, I'm using my Coty Airspun Loose Face Powder in the shade Naturally Neutral. And what I'm doing first here is using my damp sponge to go over the places that tend to either crease the most or the fastest, and then also on the places on my face that get oily, so like the center of my forehead and around my nose. Then what I'll do is just use a normal powder brush and kick off all of the excess product around my face. You can see all the powder that's just flying off there. I just want to take off everything that doesn't need to be there. Then to bronze my face and lightly contour, I'm using my Rimmel Natural Bronzer in the shade 022 Sun Bronze. And you can see I'm using just a big, fat, fluffy brush. This one's from Zoeva, and it's perfect for bronzing. And I'm just going all over the contours of my face and the perimeters, basically. And I'm just trying to warm it up and give my face a little bit of dimension. For an all-over glow, I am using my Hourglass Ambient Lighting Palette and a small, like, blush-shaped brush, and I am first going into the shade Radiant Light and putting this underneath my eyes and the very tops of my cheeks, on the center of my chin, and then also above my eyebrows. Then I'm going into the shade Incandescent Light and putting this on the highest points of my face, so cheekbones, down the bridge of the nose, Cupid's bow, and I think that's it. Yes. Then I'm going into the shade Dim Light using the same brush, and I'm just very lightly contouring my face. This gives you the most natural looking glow you could ever hope for. It's beautiful, and it definitely looks like you're glowing from within. Then for the eyes, I'm first laying down a base. So I'm using the shade Incandescent Light on a tapered fluffy brush, putting this from the lash line to the brow bone. And then I'm going into Dim Light and putting this in the crease and the outer corner. This is just a base for the shadows that I'm about to put on, and it makes your eyelids a perfect canvas for everything that's about to happen, so get ready. I'm also gonna put this on my lower lash line, just the Dim Light shade, just to make my eyes pop a little bit more and stand out without, you know, adding too much stuff. Now for a little bit of color, I'm using my Huda Beauty Rose Gold Palette, and I'm mixing the shades Shy and Sandalwood, putting that in my crease. And for those of you wondering how I did my last video's makeup, you know, the hair tutorial with the beachy waves, this part is what I did to achieve that like soft pinky look. So I'm mixing those two shades, and then I'm going back into the shade Shy and just kind of intensifying that pinky color. I want it to be more pink than peach, but still have a peach undertone. I know you know what I'm trying to say. And then I'm also gonna put this on the lower lash line for a nice haze. Then I'm going into the shade Moondust, which is a beautiful opalescent shadow, and I'm just putting this on the lower part of the lid using a flat brush, and I'm also going to pop this on the inner corners of my eyes, and it just gives a nice soft glow. Then for brows, I'm just going to quickly speed through this. I'm using my L'Oreal Brow Stylist Definer and then also my Wonder Brow. This is in the shade Brunette. This is the brow gel. I just use the tiniest little bit, and then I set it in place just by combing through the hairs and making sure they're in the right place, because trust me, they are not moving after this. Then for blush, I am going to use the shade Sensual from Tarte. This is an Amazonian Clay 12-hour blush, and I'm putting this all over my cheeks for a beautiful natural flush. For highlight, I'm going to be mixing two different ColourPop Super Shock cheek highlights. The first one I'm using here is the shade Smoke and Whistles, and this is so freaking gorgeous. I've used this so many times before, but this is like the time that I actually super duper fell in love with it. I think it is so beautiful, and it's obviously not my natural skin, but it looks so skin-like and realistic. I'm also going to put this on the high points of my brow bone, and I decided to also intensify the inner corners of my eyes. Then using my Tarte sponge, I'm just going to lift off any additional product just so it looks nice and smooth. And then I'm using the shade Monster, also from ColourPop, and just going over just the parts of my cheeks to make it look like an iridescent rosy flush. I am so in love with this, but I think the best way to use it is to layer it with another highlight. Otherwise, it's too sheer. Then for mascara, I'm using my Maybelline Colossal Lash. This is a ride or die mascara for sure. I love it. And not gonna lie, I've been using this for like several months, like way more than the 3 months that you're recommended. I'm putting this on the top and the bottom lashes, but on the lower lashes, just a very, very, very thin layer. And look, it's already feeling so fresh and wonderful. I'm so happy with it. Okay, then I'm going to just go over a few freckles and blemishes on my face that I want to hide. And to do that, I'm using my NYX little eyebrow marker in the shade medium, just creating a couple freckles that I don't actually have, but mainly going over the ones that I do have. Then I'm going to tap that in with my finger to lift off any additional product. For the lips, I'm using a matte lipstick from Maybelline. This is the shade Lust for Blush. I'm putting a coat of this on my top lip and my bottom lip, and then I'm going to remove the excess because I want this to look like a stain. So I use a little cotton round, and then I also rub it in with my finger just to make it look like I'm not wearing so much lipstick. To set my face, I'm using my L'Oreal Infallible Makeup Setting Spray, and bam, there is look number one. It is so beautiful and it looks so sweet. I think this is a gorgeous daytime look, and I feel like myself, which is so important, and I hope you like it. All right, on to the next one. I'm going into the shade Shy and also the shade Bossy from my Huda Beauty Palette, putting this in my crease from outer corner to inner corner, windshield wiper motions and little circular motions as well, really trying to build up the color there. But I also want it to be soft and blown out, so you know, you sort of be the judge of how you feel comfortable with the color. All right, then for some sparkle and fun, I'm using the shade Rose Gold. Oh my goodness, we don't even have to talk about it. I know, it is beautiful. I'm using my finger to press this in, and honestly, that is the only way that I have been successful using this shadow, because it's so sticky. You need to like warm it up with your finger and really sort of press it onto the lid in order for it to adhere to your eyelid. But oh my God, it's worth it. It's not like it's difficult or anything, but it does take a little bit of extra work. Now I'm dipping into the shade Fling with a teeny tiny little Sigma brush, and I am putting this on the inner corners of my eyes and then also on the outer corners, sort of creating a little bit of a halo eye. I want my eyes to look nice and big and round and wide open. Even though we're putting a ton of shadow on, I still want to look bright-eyed and not like overwhelmed. So I'm putting this on the outsides, and I really like the effect that this gives, and then I'm just blending it out with my finger to make sure it looks nice and smooth. Okay, then I'm mixing the shades Bossy and Coco and putting this mainly on the center part of my upper lid to just sort of connect all of those colors that are happening right there. And I just wanted a little bit more depth. Gives my lids a little bit more of a plummy haze to it. Then I'm going to use the Sigma Standout Eyes Gel Liner in the shade Liberally Toasted, and I'm putting this on my inner waterline and also my tight line. be careful with this and also just be patient. I kind of poked myself in the eye and got makeup all over my contacts and I had to go take my contacts out and then put them back in and then I messed up my makeup. It was just a whole spiel that you should just try and avoid. Then I'm going back into Bossy and Coco with a small like detailed waterline brush from Sigma and smoking this out on my lower lash line. This is just the first part of it and it is already so beautiful. It gives my eyes just this stunning like sultry look. Then I'm going into the shade Henna, which is more of a like warm brown like terracotta type of a color, and buffing this out even more to bring down that shadow and just make my eyes look even smokier. Then of course you have to pop on another layer of mascara because more is more. And then I'm also going to put on some false lashes. These are the Camellia lashes by Kiss and they are really soft and fluttery and really lightweight, and I like lightweight lashes. Now I just want to intensify my contour a little bit, so I'm using the Too Faced Chocolate Soleil bronzer. This is probably my favorite bronzer slash contour of all time, and I am just, like I said, intensifying my contours, so making sure I go underneath the jaw, also underneath the cheekbones, which is, you know, of course what you think of when you think of contouring, along the sides of my nose, and then also the temples. Then I am going to kick my highlight up a notch, even though it probably doesn't need it. I am using the Anastasia Beverly Hills Glow Kit in Gleam, and I'm mixing hard candy and crushed pearl. Look at the difference between the two sides. You can definitely tell that I did a little something extra on the other side. Now you could totally do a nude lipstick for this look. That's why I was holding that Tarte one up and it is beautiful. Trust me, that's in the shade Bestie. But I decided to go with something deeper and a little bit more sexy, I guess. And I'm using the NYX Slide On Glide On Lip Pencil in the shade Dark Soul. It's beautiful. I've used this in several tutorials before and it is so smooth and creamy and very pigmented. I'm also going to just messily fill in my lips with this. It does not have to be perfect by any means. And then I'm going in with my Ofra and Mani MUA liquid lipstick in the shade Hypno. This is the perfect shade for this look. I think it is just so stunning and I haven't used it in a tutorial before, which is shocking, but it's so beautiful. And that is the final nighttime makeup look, you guys. I think it is so beautiful and so different from the daytime look, and I really didn't have to do too much to kick it up to this level. So thank you so much for watching and happy Valentine's Day.